Welcome to the online lecture of computer science. In previous lecture, we have already started with this paper 1's chapter 4th Visual Basic. Today, we are going to start with the Visual Basic programming. So, in previous lecture, we have seen the basics of Visual Basic. We have seen the menu bar, toolbar, toolbox and function of each button in it. So in today's lecture, we are going to start with the Visual Basic programming. After completing this chapter, one can write a program in VB with few lines. So there are few terms which you have to follow while doing programming in VB. So in practical, we will see how to do programming in VB. But before that, in this lecture, we will see basically what is VB programming. So the first term, it is variable. What is variable? In VB, variables store values during a program's execution. Variables are placeholders in whom you can leave values and recall them at will. A variable has a name and value. In your code, you can refer to the value of a variable by the variable's name. Now let's see the second term, declaring variable. So variables must be declared in advance for the compilers. If the compiler knows all the variables and the types that are going to be used in the application ahead of time, it can produce an optimized code. So while declaring variables, there are two subtypes, that is explicit declaration and implicit declaration. Explicit declaration means to declare a variable, use the deem in statement followed by the variable name and type. Implicit declaration. So implicit declaration means the variable type is variant, the generic data type that can accommodate all the other data types. VB adjusts its type according to the value you assign to it. Now we will see basically the types of variables. So the first, it is the variable naming convention. So a variable name, it must begin with a letter. Can't contain any type of the declaration's character. Must not exceed 255 characters. Must be unique within its scope. The next, it is the types of variables. So the types of variables are numeric, string, boolean, date, object, variant. There are variety of numeric data types: integer, single, double, long, currency. Length strings. So length strings. String variables have variable lengths. You can also specify fixed length strings with a statement like deem some text as string. Then there are date variables and object variables. Date variables means For example, year, day 2, day 1, month, day. So these are the date variables. And the object variables, for example, deem A as command button, B as command button. So A, it is, for A caption you can write there hi, for B caption you can write there true. So declaring the variable, these were all the types of it. The third, it is the constant. Some variables don't change the value during the execution of a program. There are constants that appear many times in your code. For instance, if your program does math calculations, the value of pi 3.14159 may appear many times in your code. These values are best represented by constants. Constants don't change value. Constants are produced faster than variables. Example, public constant pi as double is equal to 3.14. So Visual Basic contains a number of predefined constants mainly using for printing and displaying. You can also create your own constant with the const statement using the same guidelines you would for creating a variable name. If option strict is on, you must explicitly declare the constant type. The next term, it is arrays. An array is a set of values which are termed elements that are logically related to each other. For example, an array may consist of the number of students in each grade in a grammar school. Example, deem salary 15. The parentheses include the maximum number of elements the array can hold. So 15, it is the maximum number of element that an array can hold. The next, it is, before that, in array there are two types, that is multidimensional array and dynamic array. So a multidimensional array, a two-dimensional array has two indices. The first identifies the row and the second identifies the column. The benefit of using multidimensional arrays is that they are conceptually easier to manage. And the second type, it is the dynamic array. Sometimes you may not know how large to make an array. Instead of making it large enough to hold the maximum number of data, you can declare a dynamic array. The next term, it is the function. A function is similar to a subroutine, but a function returns a result because a function reports a result. It must have a type. Example, date into 2 bracket returns current date. So a function is used to calculate result using given inputs. A function can be called by a procedure. Whenever a function is called, it is first compiled before being called. A select statement can have a function call. You can see here the example of the function, that is date in bracket. It returns current date ABS So it returns absolute value of its argument. So these are the built-in functions. ABS, why we use ABS function? It is the absolute value of a number. ASC, that is ASCII or ANSI code of a character. Function character. So character corresponding to given ASCII. Function cos, cosine of an angle. Function date, current date as a text string. Function now, current time and date. Function sign, sign of an angle. The next term, it is the control flow statement. So VB provides three control flow or decision structure. The first it is if then, the second it is if then else, and the third it is the select case. Now we will see these flow statements one by one. The first it is the if then. The if then structure sets the condition specified, and if it is true, executes the statement that follows. And if structure can have a single line or a multiple line syntax. Single line syntax. If condition then statement. VB evaluates the condition, and if it is true, executes the statement that follows. If the condition is false, it continues with the statement following the if structure. You can also execute multiple statements by separating them with a color. Multiple line syntax. If condition then statement. If month date equal to 1, then year. 1 then year is equal to year plus 1. Year equal to year plus 1. And if. So this is the multiple line syntax. Now we will see the second type, that is if then else. So the syntax is if condition then statement block 1, else statement block 2, if and if. If condition then statement block 1. If the condition is true, if the condition of the statement is true, then it blocks the 1. Or if the condition of the statement is false, then it blocks the 2. This is if then else. The third, it is the select case. The select case structure test is a single expression which is evaluated once at the top of the structure. The result of the test is then compared with several values. And if it matches with one of them, then the corresponding block of statements is executed. Statement block 1. In case value 1, statement block 1. In case value 2, statement block 2. Case else statement block and select. So these were the three control flow statements. Now let's start with the next term, that is loop statement. Basically, loop statement allow you to execute means to run. So it allows you to run one or more lines of code repetitively. VB supports all the loop statements. Do loop for next while band. Let's say the statements one by one. Do loop. So executes a block of statements as long as a condition is true. There are two variations of the do loop statement. A loop can be executed either while the condition is true or until the condition becomes true. These two variations use the keywords while and until to specify how long the statement will be executed. The second is for next. For next means, unlike the do loop, the for next requires that how many times the statement in the loop will be executed. For next loop uses a counter that increases decreases in value during each repetition of the loop. The third, it is the while wend. So the while wend loop executes a block of statements while a condition is true. The next term, it is the nested control structure. So you can place or nest control structures inside other control structures. Control structures in VB can be nested in as many levels as you want. Here is the structure for a nested for next loop that scans all the elements of a two-dimensional array. So you can also nest control flow structure. A user supplied value to determine if it's positive. The next, it is the event driven programming. So it forms and controls are the basic elements in the user interface of any Windows application. In VB, these elements are called objects because they are manipulated like objects. Objects have properties and methods, and they react to external events as does any physical object. A few common properties following apply to the most objects are name, appearance, back colors, four color, font, caption, text, width, height, left, top, enable, visible. Few common methods. Objects have methods. You can think of methods as the actions of an object. The first, it is the clear. It tells the control to discard its content. The second, it is the move. Lets you move and resize controls from within your application's code. The third, it is the add item, remove item, used to manipulate the items in a list box or a combo box. A few common events. Events determine the control's reactions to external condition. Controls recognize events, but your application handles them. A command button will recognize that it was clicked, but it won't react to the event unless you provide some code. Once you specify a subroutine for the controls clock event, this subroutine executes each time the control is clicked. The subroutine that determines how a control reacts to an event is called event handlers. Now we will see the mouse events. Events triggered by mouse actions. Click and double click. So the click event takes place when the user clicks the left mouse button. The double click event takes place when the user double click the left mouse button. The second is the mouse down and mouse up. Mouse down event takes place when the mouse button is pressed. The mouse up event takes place as it is released. The third, it is the mouse move, takes place continuously as the mouse is moved over a control. Next, it is the keyboard events. So it is generated by keystrokes. Usually you must program the keyboard events for the controls that can accept text. So the first, it is the key down, key up. So key down event is triggered when a key is pressed and key up when key is released. The second, it is the key press to find out which is pressed. This event is used frequently to write keyboard handlers for text boxes, because this event takes place before the character pressed is displayed in the text box. The third, it is the change, triggered by various controls when their contents change. And the fourth, it is got focus and lost focus. When the focus is moved from one control to another, the first control receives the lost focus event, and after that the second control receives the got focus event. You can use the got focus event to initialize a control for editing, and you can use the lost focus event to validate the data entered by the user. So in this way, we have completed the chapter number 4, that is Visual Basic. In your practical session, we will see how to do programming in the VB. So in exams, question will be asked that what is the use of exit statement in VB? What is array? How it is declared in Visual Basic? What are data types available in Visual Basic? Explain it. So these are the type of questions that will be asked in your exam.